The December release by Altenew is out, and just like always, there is something for everyone. However, I have here my top 3 picks. This is actually part of a blog hop. There is lots of inspiration and tons of giveaways, so if you want to join, make sure to visit my blog. So here are my top 3 favorites from the release. This is the Pots and Plants stamp set. It's an outline stamp that you can color in. Nice big focal points for your card fronts. Then of course I do have to pick one of the flower stamp sets. Very artistic looking, plus it comes with lovely sentiments. In the die set you will find dies that cut out some of the sentiments as well. And finally, this is the Old Thing Sweet stamp set. You will find chocolate, cupcakes, of course sentiments, and it's one of those layering stamp sets that you can either use the stamps to color or you can actually color the outline images. So let's go ahead and make 3 cards using all these 3 stamp sets. I'm starting with one of the plants and I'm going to stamp that with ink that is alcohol marker friendly so that I can color it in with my alcohol markers. I'm using here my alcohol markers by Altenew and this is the Green Valley set. I'm mainly using 3 colors, or on some of the leaves which are smaller, just 2 colors. The darker at the base, and as I go to the top of the leaf, I go with the lighter. I always do really quick coloring, I don't spend too much time with that, but it always looks just fine at the end. For the basket I went with vanilla colors and light brown ones, and now I'm using the matching die to cut it out. The design that I'm going for with this card is pretty basic, really easy to put together, but the size of that plant as well as a few extra touches that I will show you is going to take this card into a next level. So I'm starting out by cutting a panel that's 3.5 by 4.75. And it is a vanilla colored panel, since I wanted to stay away from vibrant white. Now this is a lovely 3D embossing folder, it's from the latest release and it gives that lovely basket look and feel. I'm inking up one of the flaps with a vanilla colored ink pad. By the way, this is Butternut, if you want to know the exact name. It is going to deepen up the edges and add some shadows on all the nooks and crannies. And I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine. By the way, this embossing folder is called Woven Basket, and I think it makes an amazing background. You can definitely use it as it is, place your basket on top and end up with a clean and simple looking card. However, I'm going to take it a step further and add a vintage look and feel on the card. So I'm going to ink up the edges, again I'm using Butternut here, and then I will move on and bring some darker shadows by using Vintage Photo. And I'm also going to bring in my die cut. I will add a little bit of shadow on one side of my basket, and then I will also get rid of that white outline just by lightly inking with whatever is left on my brush. Now my cutout looks as if I did the stamping and the coloring on craft cardstock, and it matches lovely with the background that I already have. So for the main card base I'm going with dark green one. I used foam tape to stick this panel, and then at the back of my pot again I'm going to use foam tape so that I can add even more dimension. This card design can be easily used as a masculine card as well, and I absolutely love the color combo. For the sentiment, I cut out the word hugs using gold cardstock, and this is definitely one of my favorite sentiment die cuts. I have been using it throughout the year so much, and in this case I took the time to add tiny foam tape pieces at the back to add dimension. I scattered a few gems and I'm absolutely happy with the result. Here are some close-up photos on the first card that I made for today. And here is a reminder, don't forget to like the video as well as hit that bell so that you can get notifications whenever I post a new video. And let's move on to the second card and make something really colorful. This is the Colorful Soul stamp set. I will have lots of fun with layers for this one. So I'm starting with the leaves, and since I don't know how many leaves I'm going to use, I will just rotate the paper so that I get an extra set. There are 3 layers for the leaves, so you start with a lighter ink and you can gradually darken up your ink as you go. And for the flowers, there are actually 2 flowers. I stamped one of them twice so that I end up with 3 flowers for the finished composition. And these layers are really easy to align. I actually didn't even bother to align correctly the third layer of the flowers. They are so loose. So no matter how you stamp them, they are just going to look fine. I'm using the matching dies to cut out all of the leaves and the flowers. And also one of the dies that cuts out my sentiment that I have already stamped with black ink. For this card, I'm keeping the design clean and simple. So I'm going with a white panel, however, I want to add something extra there so that it adds some interest without stealing anything from the focal points. And that's why I went with this 3D embossing folder that gives that good crane look. For the flowers, I did use foam tape at the back so that they are quite raised. However, for the leaves, I'm just using glue and I'm going to tuck them underneath the flowers. I decided to mat my panel with a green, light green colored cardstock that matches the colors of the lighter leaves, and I'm going to stick this panel on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. As you can see, I did add a few gems just here and there, and here are some close-up photos on the second card for today. And let's move on to the third card for today, where I will be using the Old Things Sweet stamp set. And with this one, you can either color yourself inside the lines or you can use the layering stamps. I decided to go with coloring it in with my alcohol markers, which is something that I rarely do when I have a layering stamp. But I mainly went with pale blue for the glass, and then I went with vanilla, light browns and darker browns to end up with this chocolate looking sundae. For the frosting, I went with pink and a little red cherry on top. I used the matching dies to cut out my image, and now for the background I will use this cover die, which is called Waveform. And I have to say, to combine those two products wasn't my idea. The idea came from the leaflet that was included in the stamp set. It's always nice to go through that. It will give you lots of options. And since I did have those wave dies, I decided to use them. I am going to use only 3 of the layers. There are many of them here. And for the layers, I went with dark chocolate brown, with craft, and with vanilla. And then my card base is going to be white, so I will end up having 4 different colors on my background. Now I want to somehow connect all those pieces, so I turn them at the back and I'm going to stick them together with foam tape. This way I will end up with one panel that I can pop on top of my card base. And here I'm just using lots of foam tape at the back to keep all those pieces together. I will stick that on top of my card base, and you can see the dimension that I got. Absolutely love it, it looks like melted chocolate at the top of the card base. I'm going to place my cutout on top, and I doubled up at the bottom so that everything is nicely leveled. Now I'm going to stamp my sentiment. I went with the word happiness from the same stamp set, and I'm stamping that with espresso, a dark brown ink, so that it matches with the rest of the colors on my card. I'm going to stamp that a couple of times to make sure that I get a good impression, and then I will add a secondary sentiment underneath that I white embossed on that dark brown cardstock. And this is going to finish off the last card for today. I'm absolutely happy with this one as well. Actually, I have to say that out of the 3 cards, this is my favorite, just because it is unique. I also love the first one with that basket woven background. Let me know in the comments below which one is your favorite. Thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. You will find a list of supplies down below, and I hope you'll all have a lovely weekend.